So at you know last week we understand up till the menstrual cycle, okay, and we studied about the male and female reproductive organs. Today we will discuss about the process of fertilization. Okay, the best time for the fertilization is 14 to 17 days after menstrual cycle. Okay, the fusion of male sperm and female ovum and sperm produces a zygote. Fertilization occurs in the oviduct. Okay, so you have to remember these terms, okay, where it is take place, okay, and what happens in these processes. Okay, this is the structure, okay, in detail in your book is given. Okay, so you have to go through it, structure and as other things, okay, because the main thing in this you have to understand that first is a single ovum is produced here. Okay, its outermost layer is known as corona radiata and inner one is known as zona pellucida. Okay, so this is the ovum inside it. Okay, and this is the process. See the structure. This is sperm, and when they fuse with this ovum, it is known as fertilization. After that, the development of embryo is start. Okay, it is two-celled embryo, and it after the form further. Okay, you can say that metamorphosis is goes to the four-celled embryo. Okay, and then after, you can see the different type of structure what happen in the fallopian tube. Okay, so you have to understand in that after they planted, as you know that this fertilized embryo will be developed in the uterus. Okay, so this uterine wall in this uterus it is gone. Okay, so this then it forms the blastocyst. Okay, then the blastulation process will be happened and the blastomas in the last stages from the blastula. Okay, then after that it is completed its metamorphosis and organ development will be start after that. Okay, so one time read from book also, then this is just a you could say in brief you have to understand these important terms. Okay, then structure of a sperm. Okay, if we because it is an important topic, because sometimes many questions will be asked in exam from this topic. Okay, so a sperm has a head, middle piece and a tail. Okay, so first you have to understand that it has three parts. Okay, head, middle piece and a tail. Okay, the head contains an acrosome. So you have to understand that sometime uppermost part of sperm can be asked, so it is acrosome. Okay, at the top of which secretes an enzyme also. So it is also secrete an enzyme. Okay, its name is halogenase. Okay, which dissolve the wall of the ovum for the entry of sperm. Okay, so it, role of this enzyme also you have to understand. It actually dissolve the wall of ovum. Okay, for the entry of the sperm. The nucleus of the head contains 23 chromosomes, that is 22 and one chromosome. Okay, 22 plus X. Okay, or 22 plus Y. So you have to understand sometime. Question also asked that sperms contain the sex chromosome is one or two. So you have to understand it is only one. It either X or either Y. Okay, the middle piece has mitochondria which provides energy for the movement of sperm. So mitochondria also present in this sperm. Okay, the main function of this mitochondria is to provide energy for the movement of sperm. Okay, so that's why it has a tail which help in its movement also. Okay, so you can see in the image also the lashing movement of the tail helps the sperm to move forward. Okay, so the movement of this tail helps the sperm to move in forward direction. Okay, so this is the human spermatogone. Okay, so it has the different parts, head, okay, middle piece and tail. Okay, so centrioles, and because division occur here, so centriole also formed. Okay, nuclear or chromosomal material are in it. Okay, it is known as DNA mainly. Okay, which pass through one generation to another generation. Okay, so this is the main human spermatozoan structure. If you see the structure of an ovum is a small spherical cell. It has a large cytoplasm and a nucleus. The nucleus has 23 chromosomes. Okay, it has all 23 chromosomes. Okay, so if you see the structure carefully, okay, so an ovum with its protective coverings. So coverings are called as the cells of coronary aorta. Okay, the further is genu pellucida. Okay, so this is a space is found just before this ovum. Okay, the main nucleus, you can say. Okay, it is known as vitelline space. Okay, then vitelline membrane, then nucleus, then cytoplasm within it. Okay, so this is the structure of a ovum. Then implantation occurs. Okay, it is the attachment of blastocyst, a hollow ball of many cells. Okay, which we understand further. Okay, on the wall of the uterus mainly. Okay, so then placenta. Placenta is what? Placenta is disc-like structure attached to the wall of uterus, which produces hormone. Okay, like estrogen, progesterone, and relaxing. Okay, so these hormones prevent the formation of new follicles in the ovaries. Okay, during pregnancy, these maintain the endometrium relaxation of the muscles of the uterine. Okay, it is made up to above two sets of finger-like structures known as the villi. Also, okay, villi as in found in our small intestine. Also, the same finger-like structures also present here. The blood of mother and the fetus never mingles. Okay, the placenta provide oxygen and nutrients from the mother to the fetus. So it removes carbon dioxide and wastes such as urea from the fetus to the mother. It also acts as temporary endocrine gland. So you can say it as a temporary endocrine gland because it secretes some hormones. Okay, because it occurs for the short while time. Okay, during pregnancy, that's why it is known as the temporary endocrine gland. So you can see this structure. Okay, fetus with uterus and fully developed fetus here. Okay, these are the placental villi or finger-like projection you can see here. Okay, and the further is mainly, it has three parts. We will discuss in the further. Okay, when we read about the fetal membrane. So fetal membrane, it is clear these structures. There are four membranes covering the embryo. Okay, these are amnion, corion, allantois, and yolk sac. The question often asked in exam also that amnion is present only in the chordates one. Okay, so amnion, corion, okay, allantois, and yolk sac. These are the four membranes which covers the embryo. So amnion is the innermost membrane. Amnion is the innermost membrane covering the fetus, and allantois is associated with corion. Both are known as choriolentonic membrane. Okay, choriolentonic membrane. So functions of these are chorion and allantois provide nourishment and remove wastage. Okay, from the embryo, and yolk sac is the region of the formation of blood cell. So blood cell, sometime question also asked. Okay, so these are the minute things. So you have to understand that yolk sac is the region where the formation of blood cell occurs. Amnion is the membrane which covers the embryo. Amniotic fluid fills the space between the amnion and the fetus. Okay, mainly it is the protective covering. Okay, of the embryo. So first function of amniotic fluid is it protects the embryo from mechanical jerks. Okay, so whenever you see in the structure of heart, okay, where pericardium fluid is found. Okay, so whenever these fluids are found within the cells, okay, or any organ, these mainly first their function is to prevent the embryo from mechanical jerks, and it keeps a uniform pressure around the embryo also. Okay, and it prevents the sticking of embryo to the amnion. Okay, because it is a fluid-like structure, so it prevents sticking also. Then we have to read about the gestation, okay, period or pregnancy period. So it is the carrying of the developing young ones in the uterus. It being fertilized till the birth of the baby. In humans, this gestation period is 280 days. Okay, you have to remember it, 280 days. Then the childbirth, and if you say that parturition is brought about by a series of rhythmic contraction of the uterus. Okay, the hormone oxytocin. So you have to remember that this hormone, we read earlier also about it. Okay, which mainly known as antidiuretic hormone, okay, ADH. So it also has a function to stimulate the smooth muscle contracts in the uterine wall. So two function it have to serve in our body. Second one, there are three stages for this process. Okay, first dilation of the cervix, second expulsion of the fetus out of the uterus, and delivery of the placenta. So there are some roles of sex hormones. First is in males, okay, these testosterone mainly secreted by the testes, okay, the functions of testosterone is deeper voice, broader shoulders, okay, larger larynx, growth of beard, growth of hair in pubic region, etc. In females, hair growth in the armpits and pubic region, development of breasts, curved hips, high pitch voice, maintaining of pregnancy, and regulates lactation, etc. So these are the roles of secondary hormones. And sometimes in previous questions, sometimes asked that difference between identical twins and fraternal twins. Okay, so first is what are the identical twins? When you hear about the term twins, okay, it is also two types. One is identical twins formed by the splitting of one fertilized egg only. Okay, one fertilized egg into two equal parts. When one fertilized egg is split into two equal parts, it is known as identical twins. Okay, each part of it develops into separate individuals. It share a common placenta and resembles each other and are of same sex. Okay, so these are known as identical twins. So in your nearby, or if you know some person, sometimes this happen that identical twins are born, okay, which are of same sex, means both are boys or both are girls, like this. These are known as identical twins. But fraternal twins are fraternal twins forms by the fertilization of two eggs, okay, at the same time with different appearance, having individual placenta and sex may be same or may be male or female. Okay, it can be same or can be different. Okay, this type of mainly twins occur very in the, you can say very minute, these structures with these type of twins occur. Okay, the chances are